John was showing you that the rain showers continue along the I-95 corridor, but to our west, starting to see a break in the action as far as the rain is concerned. So the steady, consistent rain will start to dry out from west to east. As I said, particularly Prince George's County, Annapolis, Highway 50, I-95 corridor, still going to pick up plenty of that rain, but to our west. Good news, Adam, is that we'll get a break for the next several hours before the next round of rain moves our rain.
Then we'll take the break. And thanks, Clay. Latest news and weather anytime with our NBC Washington app. For now, back to the Today Show.
If you're struggling with press, you're not alone. Talking to you, Ryan Gosling.
You're right about where you dumb bitch.
When I started doing press, Ron Frosted, I was like you. Funny, good-looking. Now look at me.
7 years old.
You think this is how I wanted to spend my 26th birthday?
That is Jerry Seinfeld making a surprise appearance during Weekend Update on last night's new episode of Saturday Night Live. Dua Lipa holds double duty as both host and musical guest. Speaking of hard workers, over the past 20 years, Chris Pine has been one of the most successful leading men on the big screen. Think about it. He's played characters like Captain Kirk, Jack Ryan, as well as Steve Trevor in the Wonder Woman blockbusters. Now, as they say, for something completely different. Pine dreamed up, wrote, produced, directed, and stars in the new independent film, Pool Man. Shot the movie in 21 days on a modest budget, telling the story of one man's life in the city where Pine grew up. Willie got together with Chris here in New York this week for a Sunday sit-down.
Chris Pine is recognized as a go-to actor in Hollywood, even if he's not always recognized on the street.
In the past week, I've gotten Jim Carrey and Jeff Daniels. I did get George Hamilton in this movie.
George Hamilton?
There's no offense to George Hamilton, but it's just the age disparity thing. It's a little rough for me. Mayo wasn't super happy with that one. I have made these big films, but I'm not a Tom Cruise. I'm not a big mega movie star.
The 43-year-old had starred as the legendary Captain Kirk in 3 Star Trek movies.
You okay?
That's better. Just another man of fleet.
Played military man Steve Trevor alongside Gal Gadot's Wonder Woman. And a royal love interest in The Princess Diaries 2.
You can step on my foot anytime.
In his latest film, Pool Man, Pine is a much different kind of leading man. His character, Darren Barrowman, cleans pools when he's not working righteously to root out corruption in Los Angeles.
I need to turn out taking them down.
My daughter cover.
Yes.
Can I get back to you?
Believe it or not, Pine relates better to Darren than to those strong, hunky characters that made him famous.
I think people have seen the posters around. They're like, is that Chris Pine? Okay, that's Chris Pine. What is he up to?
Yeah.
So how do you explain what this film is to people?
In many ways, it is an ode to Los Angeles, a love letter. But really, ultimately, it's an ode to this part of myself I've carried with me always, which is this awkward void that I've felt for, you know, so long. This, in many ways, is closer to me than anything else I've played. You know, I think when I started getting cast as the leading man and the handsome guy in these films, it was such a joke to me, so deeply ironic.
It's funny, I'm thinking of people watching this and going, what is Chris Pine talking about that he was awkward? Young. So who was that kid before we met this movie star? Who's the guy you're talking about?
Well, I was a very sensitive child. I classify myself more probably as an introvert than as an extrovert. So I guess that's what I'm saying is when I started to get my, at the beginning of my career getting cast in these parts, the prince, literally the prince, the sense of being a fraud was so deep, and I'm kind of on the joke now, but I feel much more authentically myself in a character like Darren Barrowman.
In his directorial debut, Pine calls the shots for an A-list cast that includes Annette Bening and Danny DeVito.
I got him, Diane. Boys got a move. Let him move.
Yeah, this is not about you, okay? This is Darren's life.
So if I asked Danny or Annette what kind of director you are, what do you think they'd tell me?
I think the fun of working at that pace cases, you have to be supple. I like that word, supple. You can't be rigid. You know, allowing for what they want to bring to it, I guess. I don't know. Hopefully they like that.
This is my take on the language
it's brilliant. I'm curious for you what it feels like, maybe different than other movies, to be sitting here a few days out from the world eating your baby. And by that I mean,
oh, it's,
you wrote it, directed, produced,
terrifying. And it's absolutely terrifying. And there's something really satisfying after a period of 20 years where you're a hired hand to be like, no, this is my work, you know. It's deeply vulnerable, and it's been terrifying, I would say, a lot of the time, but it's been deeply gratifying.
Yeah, that's yours.
Yeah, I can own all of it.
Yeah.
But that is where the vulnerability comes in. I can't hide my...
Pine was born in Los Angeles to a family of actors. His father, Robert Pine, played the sergeant on the hit show Chips. His grandmother and mother were actors too. Pine didn't find acting until he went to college at Cal Berkeley.
My father was in a really successful TV show until 1981. I was born in 80, but then, you know, gigs started not coming around so much, and auditions petered out. It was, you know, a rough like 15 or so years where I saw how absolutely brutal and fickle and really hard business can be. So I'm very aware of the rarity of my position, because I know more often than not it's what my parents went through for a long time.
So none of that deterred you, though? Did your parents
see my parents saw me in a play in college, and my mother, I remember, this is not hyperbole, said, are you sure you don't want to become a lawyer? And she didn't say it jokingly. And I said no. She took a moment and she said, okay. She knew what I was going up against.
Yeah.
Potentially going up against. And so my parents have been nothing but supportive.
Pine started with small parts on TV shows like ER and CSI Miami before landing the role of Anne Hathaway's love interest in the hit 2004 Princess Diaries sequel.
I was driving on the freeway, it's the height of summer, and I got a call from my agents, and I booked a job, and I pulled over onto the side of the freeway, and they said, getting paid $65,000. And it was like, they just told me I made $50 million. It was absolutely earth-shattering. I had an overdraft in my bank account. It was like $400 over, and I was gonna have to ask my parents for money. And I got that 65, and I just remember distinctly knowing in that moment that my life had changed somehow. Even though 60 at the end of the day turned out to be about $15,000.
Right. I don't tell you that.
Oh, that's rent money. It's a wild thing. I'll never forget that. And remembering what my folks had to go through. So I'm living, living a dream.
2 decades into a career that has exceeded his dreams, Chris Pine is grateful and humble with a little help from the public.
He had a whole encounter with this woman in Washington, D.C. She's convinced I was Matt Damon.
Did you go with it?
Yes, I went with her.
She's going to get home and someone's going to finally tell her.
I know.
That's Chris Pine.
I know.
It's been an honor to talk to Matt Damon. I love you, Nathan.
Pool Man hits theaters this Friday, May 10th. Our thanks to the Pebble Bar right here at Rockefeller Center for hosting Willie and Chris. Don't forget to subscribe to the Sunday Sit Down podcast to hear Willie's full extended interview with Chris Pine. There is much more in there. You can find it on Apple Podcasts or wherever you get yours. And next week, Willie's Sunday Sit Down with our NBC neighbor, Jimmy Fallon, as he celebrates 10 years at The Tonight Show. He's reflecting on his ride from childhood comedy fan to SNL, the biggest job in Lakeland. Willie and Jimmy, next week on Sunday Today. Let's turn now and get another quick check of your local Sunday weather.
Hi everyone, meteorologist Clay Anderson. The soggy weather across the Washington Capital Region continues, but we will have some clearing coming in from the west across the region, so the steady rain will finally get that break. As you see, looking right now at live Storm Team 4 radar, showing you that these rain showers are ending, but if you are traveling along area highways, make sure that you are careful when you step outside, because temperatures will be rising today to about 70 degrees. Everyone enjoy your Sunday.
On Sunday Today, our highs and lows of the week, including a very persistent woodpecker. will tell you if it got anyone to answer the door. But up next, our Sunday spotlight on the new Sculpture Park in Alabama. It's taking visitors through the same journey that enslaved people were once brought through. The lessons its founders hope to pass along today.
Time.